impeach him. Really? Really? For what? You're gonna sue me for doing my job? Okay.
That, of course, is President Obama. He was chiding House Republicans in front of some supporters in Texas this past week. House Speaker John Boehner at the same time was announcing he's going to be suing the president over the president's executive actions regarding the health care law. Joining me around the table are four members of the House, Marsha Blackburn, Republican from Tennessee, and her Republican colleague Aaron Schock from Illinois, Beto O'Rourke, Democrat from Texas, and Donna Edwards, Democrat from Maryland. Thank you all so much for joining us. So let's start with the politics of the lawsuit. Since we try to specialize in politics here, and that is, we've already seen Democratic letters raising funds off both the lawsuit and threats of impeachment, and we have seen Republican conservatives sort of pushing Boehner on and talking the next step, impeachment. So how does this play as you all look toward the midterms?
I'll jump in on that. The lawsuit is about process. And the American people appreciate and want an orderly process. And to them, the means is as important as the ends. And what they have seen is a president who has gone outside of his constitutional authority and is trying to make his own laws. And what they have repeatedly said, and Candy, this isn't a partisan issue. We hear about it from Democrats, from Republicans, from independents. We hear a lot about it from women. There is an expectation that the president will conduct himself in a certain manner and that he is going to follow the letter of the law. We are a nation of laws. And I've got to tell you, a lot of constitutional scholars are on our side in this debate.
I've really got to jump in here. I don't understand the politics, quite frankly. I mean, 74% of Republicans support the Affordable Care Act, and so they're suing against their own Republicans. They wanted a delay in the individual mandate. In fact, in the House passed a delay of the individual mandate, and now they're suing over the individual mandate. Most of American people want to focus on jobs in the economy. We've had 52 straight months of positive job growth, 6.1% unemployment. People want to focus on jobs, extending unemployment, raising the minimum wage, and what's on the Republicans' leaderboard? Suing the president and impeaching the president. Nope, I don't understand the politics.
And we should say that the speaker has said no impeachment's not on his board. We are hearing Republicans talk about it, but not the bulk of Republicans. Congressman Schock, look, the thing is, I don't know how Americans look at this, but my guess is they'd look up and think, what are they doing now? The speaker's suing the president. And I don't think they necessarily blame one or the other, but they just see a Washington that does not function, children at the border, a health care system. I mean, how does this, play?
I think this lawsuit is about a number of things, but first and foremost, it's about the rule of law. And the fact of the matter is we have a president who has boasted at rally after rally that if Congress doesn't pass the laws that he wants, he will act unilaterally and implement his own laws. I don't care what your political philosophy is, and I don't care what your political view of this process is. We have a constitution, and every 2 years, each of the four of us around this table take an oath. We raise our right hand, and we swear to protect and defend the Constitution of the United States. This lawsuit is more than just about holding the president within his realm of authority, which is to faithfully execute the laws that Congress passes. It's also about us fulfilling our constitutional responsibility, our oath to protect and defend the Constitution. If we allow this president to write his own laws, to implement his own laws outside of the bounds and purview of the Congress, we will open the floodgates for future presidents of Republicans and Democrats to do the same, and that's a dangerous precedent to set.
Made some tactical errors in dealing with Congress, because what's happened here, I mean, outside legal errors and whether there is substantial evidence for a suit, has he made errors in dealing with Congress?
I don't know, and as you probably know, I'm a freshman. I've only been here for about 18 months, But
in terms of the merits of the argument, my understanding is that this president has authored fewer executive actions than almost any other president preceding his presidency in recent history. But furthermore, and probably more importantly, the veterans that I represent in El Paso want us to fix the VA. Those who are unemployed in El Paso want us to work on the economy. People are asking us what we're going to do about this humanitarian crisis on the Texas-Mexico border. So that's what my constituents, what I think most people in America want us to work on. I happen to think this lawsuit is a waste of time and resources and focus when we have some very serious issues confronting this country.
Let me get you in.
My Democratic colleagues, do they believe that the president is faithfully executing the laws of the Congress? Do they believe
that the
crisis at the border
is
a result
of the president? Faithfully executing the laws. And if you want to talk about the crisis at the border, it has been exacerbated by the fact that Republicans refuse to address immigration reform.
There are three equal branches of government, and the president is to do what he is to implement the laws. The Supreme Court has 12 times said, look, you are outside of your jurisdiction. The president is trying to consolidate his power. The American people don't like it. They talk about jobs, the economy, Obamacare. What they say is, look at the uncertainty that this president and this administration is interjecting in the normal course of doing business.
The president wants to act. The president wants to get something done. Absence
well,
and the failure
in the
of
manner
Republicans
allowed to
in the
him
Congress
and not trying to make his own laws and be an imperial president.
I got to take a break here, but I want to quick play a couple of sound bites. These were not an exchange per se between President Obama and the Speaker of the House, but it is a tit for tat between the two of them. I want to play it and then go into break, and I'm going to come back and ask you what you think people hear when they hear this sort of thing. Go ahead.
If we don't secure the border, nothing's going to change. And if you look at the president's request, it's all more about continuing to deal with the problem.
Congress just said no to fixing our broken immigration system. These guys still can't get their act together.
He's been president for 5.5 years. When's he going to take responsibility for something?
You're going to use taxpayer money to sue me for doing my job while you don't do your job.
Can this marriage be saved? We're going to talk about that when we come back, also about the problem on the border.